Protests are still going on outside Wisconsin's state capitol, but Governor Scott Walker says he's not backing down when it comes to the budget. Walker took his case straight to voters Tuesday evening with a speech from his capitol office that he called a fireside chat.
As more and more protesters come in from Nevada, Chicago, and elsewhere, I'm not going to allow their voices to overwhelm the voices of the millions of taxpayers from all across this state who know we're doing the right thing.
Wisconsin Democrats are doing everything they can to stall the Republican governor's plan to strip unionized public workers of most of their bargaining rights. Democratic lawmakers in the state assembly have introduced more than 100 amendments in an effort to delay the vote. And Senate Democrats left town last week to avoid it altogether. Governor Walker warned that their continued absence could have dire consequences.
Failure to act on this budget repair bill means at least 1,500 state employees will be laid off before the end of June. If there's no agreement by July 1st, another 5,000 to 6,000 state workers, as well as 5,000 to 6,000 local government employees, would also be laid off.
Walker would not say which jobs he would go after first. Disputes over state budget proposals are not limited to Wisconsin. In Ohio, Republican Governor John Kasich is backing a measure that would end collective bargaining rights for state workers there.
I don't want anybody to lose their job, because they have to be aware and wake up, because concessions have to be made.
President Barack Obama, who was in Ohio Tuesday, has said that limiting bargaining rights seems more like an assault on unions. Some of these protesters took that argument a step further, saying the plan is an attack on the middle class as a whole.
The country is getting more and more divided between rich and poor, and the attempt of Senate Bill 5 is to take away protections from public workers. Kind of, they're the last people who have protection.
And in New Jersey, Governor Chris Christie, a conservative who has built a national reputation for fiscal discipline, unveiled a $29.4 billion budget that calls for heftier contributions from state workers for pension and health care benefits. The Christie proposal has also been opposed by union workers. The powerful Democratic constituency is now preparing for its own statehouse rally. Thousands are expected to converge on New Jersey's capital in support of Wisconsin's public employees on Friday. Brian Thomas, The Associated Press.